brand new revision of the BIOS interface. Envelope UI design and simplified structure, making the configuration interface more visual. Online help below parameters, providing quick introductions. Support for mouse operations, making the interface user-friendly. This video uses BIOS 5.15 of the R9600 G5 server as an example. Press the Escape or Delete key when the BIOS startup screen opens. For BIOS 5.06 and later versions of the G5 series Intel servers, you can directly access the graphical BIOS interface. For BIOS 2.00.39 and later versions of the G3 series Intel servers, you must first set the setup mode to graphic before you can access the graphical BIOS interface. Set the system time and date. You can use either the mouse or arrow keys on the keyboard. Access the advanced menu, then select socket configuration and then processor configuration. You can view the frequency and type of processors. To configure processor parameters, pull the scroll bar down or hold the left mouse button on the middle of the page and then drag the mouse. For information about the parameters, see the related BIOS user guide. Press the Escape key or click the back button to return to the upper layer menu. Select memory configuration, and then select memory topology. You can view information about each DIMM. Access the security menu. By default, no BIOS passwords are set. BIOS passwords include a power on password as well as an administrator password and a user password for BIOS setup. The power on password is required each time the server starts up. The administrator password or the user password is required each time you enter the BIOS setup screen. You can set a password as needed. The new password is required at the next startup. Select the password to delete. Enter the current password and click OK. In the dialog box that opens, click OK. Access the server menu and select HDM network configuration. You can view and set the HDM management IP address. You can view network information about HDM dedicated and shared network ports. To manually specify the HDM management IP address, select Static for configuration address source, and then enter the IP address and subnet mask. To avoid network failures, make sure the HDM shared network port and dedicated network port are on different network segments. Access the boot menu, and then set the boot mode and the server boot order. Supported boot options include hard disk, network, CD, DVD, and other device. This example sets PXE port 2 as the first boot option. Access the network drive BBS priorities submenu, and set the network port as the first boot option. Then, return to the boot menu, and set network as the first boot option. At the next startup, the server will boot the operating system in the configured order. To set the BIOS boot mode, select Boot Mode Select field and choose UEFI or Legacy. Access the exit menu, select a save option. To exit the BIOS with changes saved, select Save Changes and Exit or press F4. To restore the default settings, select Restore Defaults or press F3. To display the general help window, click the Help button on the sidebar or press F1. To directly boot the operating system from a boot device, select the boot device for boot override and press Enter. Please verify the modified BIOS settings in the pop-up dialog box before saving the configuration. The modification will take effect after server restart.